how do you distinguish a materialistic humanist from a spiritual humanist? I'll give the litmus test, and I've done that at some of the meetings. So last one was at the House of Commons. I said that the way you distinguish between these two humanists is as follows. A materialist humanist, if you tell him, why should I be here well with you, or why shouldn't I hurt you? He'll say, look, Mr. Lakhani, we follow the golden rule. This is the heart of materialistic humanism. We follow the golden rule. I don't step on your toes, you don't step on my toes. I don't steal from you, you don't steal from me. This is how we act with the rest of humanity. We do business with the rest of humanity. We do commerce. This is how we link with the rest of humanity. I don't do this to you, you don't do this to me. We cannot have a contract. And this is, if you like, the throbbing heart of materialistic humanism. You see how it fails miserably. This is just commerce. What comes with spiritual humanism is dramatically different. It says the reason why I don't hurt you and I try and help you is because the same spirit that is percolating through these eyes is percolating through those eyes. If I see somebody struggling in front of me, it is natural for me, not because that God is keeping a score on it or that because I want to do business with you, I just can't help myself but help you. I can't help myself but help you. And why I don't feel like hurting a living thing? The same thing that's manifesting here is manifesting there. So I don't wish to step on it for unnecessary reason, for no reason. Why should I do that? That's why when you see a living thing being killed in front of your eyes, we go, ouch! It shows the deeper level of linkage we have with the rest of the living kingdom. That's why you go, ah, even if a small bird gets hit, you know, an animal gets hit, you immediately go, ouch! The spirit has been touched. So you know why, not at a material level, not because you're doing business with that individual. So the way I said it in a very rude way perhaps is the way you distinguish a spiritual humanist from it is very simple. When you meet a materialistic humanist, his face becomes screwed up. It appears almost constipated, you know. He gets very stressed out. Do you know why? It is time for business. I don't step on your toes, you don't step on my toes. I don't steal. See, this is the way he looks at reality, at other human beings. He wants to do business now.
And I'll put the right mask on.
So that's why, you know, the face is screwed up. I mean, the famous materialistic humanist, you know, his face is always screwed, he's always tense. Why is he so tense? Suppose he's got his stuff right. Suppose materialistic humanism is the reality. We should be relaxed about life and talk to human beings at a human level. He can't do it, he's stressed up straight away. Why? Materialistic human, he wants to do business. Spiritual humanist, when you meet him, his face lights up. He sees himself reflected in you. He says, oh, he falls in love with humanity. This is the difference between spiritual humanism and the kind of very crass, lifeless, materialistic humanism, which I continue to criticize, saying, chaps, you need to grow up. Humanism is the right thing. You've got the right idea. You're in the right direction. But qualify it as spiritual humanism and not materialistic humanism, which is lifeless, boring, and stodgy. You're not a lump of carbon. Come on, Mr. You know, grow up. There's much more to you than matter. Mm. And this is called spiritual humanism. Now, let me tell you my experience. Whenever I present these ideas in contrast to materialistic humanism, I steal the hearts and minds of almost every youngster I've come across. They love it. They know there's something more to them than just a lump of carbon that got wound up through accident of evolution. Yeah. There's much more to us. They all know it, but they know it intuitively, not intellectually. So intellectually, they kind of, you know, side with materialistic humanism because they've got nothing better. But intuitively, they know something is missing. And what that's what they're doing. Materialistic humanism is lifeless. It is stodgy. It cannot be appealing. You need humanity, interact with humanity in this humane manner. So we are much more than the animal or material. We are the spirit.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism, sponsored by People Care, encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.